Oh my god, we finally have a new Fractal Design enclosure. I really want something fresh from them. You know, I love the Define R6. I love the Meshify C. I use that in my personal Ryzen system. The Define S2 was a bit underwhelming, and I'm hoping the Vector RS will satisfy. Wait a second, the interior looks familiar. I see what's going on. They're just trying to refresh the exterior. Now, price-wise, you're looking at $179 for the Dark TG and TG models, so that is pretty competitive. It's just slightly more versus the Define R6 or the Define S2. So Fractal Design keeping the Vector RS a bit more of a premium release versus their own other series. So let's see how they did, shall we? Right after this.
With long battery life, an NVIDIA MX 150 GPU, and Intel Core i7 processor in a compact design, the Razer Blade Stealth 13 is a great companion for users on the go. If you want more gaming power, hook it up to the Core X eGPU with support for both AMD and NVIDIA GPUs. The Razer Blade Stealth plus the Core X, the ultimate power couple.
All right, so the first thing I want to say is that the interior is identical to the Define R6, so make sure to watch that video to get acquainted with all the configurations that you can do by removing the whole hard drive cage and opening up that entire interior to basically turn this into an S2 enclosure. But the exterior is basically where all the changes and all the differences are between the Vector RS and the Define R6. The I/O has been relocated, but it's been kept the same with dual USB 3s, a Type-C Gen 2 port, audio jacks, and power reset switches too. The case feet are different. They are silver and they are plastic. Initially, I thought they were aluminum. I was like, that's pretty awesome and premium, but nope. The side ventilation pattern has been redesigned to face down. This is to optimize for airflow and to minimize noise. And of course, the whole exterior redesign with the added angular patterns for both the top and the front panels. I do like the dual surface approach for the front and the top panels, having glass pieces plus metal. So you have that transparent element for the top, so you can see your entire system and it kind of like opens up the whole case a little bit more. It's a cool pattern for this angular exterior, but also reminds me of the NZXT Phantom enclosure and somewhat of a Silverstone enclosure. So it's kind of like a hybrid between those two brands. It doesn't necessarily feel to me like a Fractal Design release. But of course, all the looks are subjective, so let me know how you feel about the appearance of the Vector RS. I personally don't really like it. That could be because of the size of the enclosure. Like, it's absolutely massive. It is an R6, the Define R6 with the Define S2, but slightly expanded for both the front and the top because of the additional panels. Unfortunately, the few negatives that come with the angular top TG panel is dust accumulation, finger marks, and because it's angled, you can't really put items on it because they will slide off. It is glass after all. I will say though, I do not like the height of the front panel and how it spans the entire height of the enclosure, which means you cannot pick up the case by the front. You have to resort to other means or removing that front panel completely, which by the way, you have to do in order to access the bottom dust filter. Now, I love their approach for integrated case lighting that is tasteful, it's ambient, it's ARGB, so you connect this to your motherboard if you want to sync everything up, or Fractal Design actually includes this controller that is magnetic, which is awesome, and you can press those buttons to like select your color if you do not have a compatible motherboard. Now, the Define R6 was all about modularity and being able to remove the entire hard drive cage area and open up that interior. Obviously, that is also available here, but Fractal Design have stepped up their game in terms of making sure that this whole modularity approach is also transferred to the exterior now that you can swap out the top TG panel for a mesh panel. So you can remove the front panel, take off the glass top panel, install a fan bracket, then install a dust filter, and finally install a mesh panel up top in case you're doing any sort of water cooling or airflow options at the top. And obviously all the same fan mounts and radiator mounts from the R6 carry over because it's basically the same interior in terms of fan and radiator options. This is one of the best, I would say, in terms of being able to mount like a 420 rad up top, a 360 at the front, and having everything kind of like work together without it being too compact or too large. And for water cooling, this thing is absolutely awesome. As for the interior, we have that hard drive area on the right side beside the motherboard. Up to EATX motherboards are supported. We have that ventilated power supply shroud, and three 140mm fans are included, two for the intake and one for exhaust, spinning at 1000 RPM, and they're connected via a 3-pin fan headers, so they are not PWM controlled. Now looking at the back, we have two additional SSD caddies. We also have a fan hub that is PWM controlled or can be powered via SATA. We also have six hard drive cages that are modular along the height of that entire side section. Plus we have Velcro straps beside all the main rubber grommets and so many cable tie points that if you do a bad cable management job, it is really on you. There's also a vertical dual slot GPU mount, but it is pretty close to the side panel, so it's probably good for water cooling only or for blower style carts. The riser cable, by the way, is optional. You have to purchase that separately. In terms of the assembly procedure, it is absolutely flawless. One of the best user experiences you can get in terms of building inside a case. I absolutely love that the audio cable has now been routed to the back and like properly positioned where it will be exiting near the bottom left on the motherboard. The rubber grommets in particular are one of the best. It's like little things that make you feel like this is a premium enclosure where they hide the cable without showing anything that is behind it. If you're one of those people that requires a whole stack of hard drives inside an enclosure, the Vector RS or the Definer 6 is for you. We have six drive caddies in here. You can maneuver them based on the height and kind of like open up a little bit of the airflow channels. It's awesome, but this is not my approach personally. I'm all about SATA SSDs and M.2 SSDs. So that whole right section is pretty wasteful and useless to me personally. And as for cable management, I put in zero effort, as you can see, but the side panel closes just fine. As for temperatures, this is a bit surprising because the CPU is about average, while the GPU is very toasty inside the Vector RS. Even when I open the front panel completely, we do drop 7.5 degrees on the CPU, but not so much on the GPU. And when I install the mesh top panel without the dust filter, the temperatures actually increase for the GPU and drop slightly for the CPU. So it seems like the GPU temperatures are pretty toasty inside the Vector RS. It doesn't seem like there's enough airflow in the bottom of the case, even after I lowered those two front fans to have a bit more directional air for the GPU. It actually did not do anything for the temperatures. And I'm assuming it's targeted towards custom loops where you can install massive radiators for the top and the front and remove some of that heat buildup that happens with those heat pockets, especially around the GPU area. As for the noise profile, this is a very quiet enclosure. Even when I installed the top mesh panel, it's slightly louder on the side profile, but still totally manageable and the system has been running behind me this entire time I'm on camera. Totally manageable. And so for the conclusion, I want to say that my preference for this external redesign has changed slightly as soon as I turned on the system and I saw this beautiful ambient strip LED that kind of like brings all the corners and this angular pattern together. But without it, it looks kind of boring. Personally, it's not a case for me. I would never use that many hard drive slots beside the motherboard. And if you are going the water cooling route, all that space is available for extra radiators and push-pull configurations. So that is awesome for individuals who are going the water cooling custom loop route, but then you're kind of wasting all the hard drive storage. You might as well get the Define S2 instead. I do appreciate them taking the risk and doing something totally different on the exterior because this is not what I would associate with Fractal design, but I'm guessing it's all about subjective preference and you let me know if you like this design or like what they've been so known for in terms of the Define series. Personally, this is not for me, but it's all up to you. So let me know in the comments how you feel. I'm Dmitry, thanks so much for watching. Check out this other relevant content and subscribe for more. I'll see you next video.